to be happy at work, you don't have to do what you love, but rather love what you do.
I was scheduled to speak for a client, and it was going to be a fantastic opportunity for people less than 2 years in that organization to learn some tangible tools and takeaways that would help them in their career. Then COVID-19 happened and everything shut down. But in conversation with the client, we recognized that these employees were still looking for education. They still needed inspiration and they still wanted humor. We realized, while we might not all be able to get together in the same room, our ideas could come together.
I'm really excited to welcome you to our first virtual career day with you all in Boston. You know, I think especially now, humor and learning to adapt to where we are is so important. And I believe that Andrew's message and his philosophy will really resonate with you. I'm thrilled to turn things over and officially welcome Drew Tarvin to your screens.
The beautiful thing is with technology can be coming to you live virtually from New York.
It was important for us to still create an experience. We didn't want to do a webinar. We wanted to do a virtual keynote. We want it to be informative, engaging, and entertaining. So we focused on increasing the standard production values.
Not only will you see this wonderful view of me, you'll also get a chance to be able to see just my slides. You'll also get a picture-in-picture view, so a combo of those two things together, where you can see me and the slides. And then finally, we also have an additional angle. This is kind of my vanity angle.
We also incorporated interactive exercises.
I want to demonstrate that with a quick activity. So this you can do at home. So again, on your right hand, give a thumbs up. On your left hand, give a finger forward. And then now just switch the two. And you can switch back and forth, back and forth.
We encouraged engagement.
Think about it. How many of you are constantly learning? And go ahead and feel free to like raise your hand, even though no one can kind of see you. It's just kind of some physical movement. Anyone done learning? Is anyone like, nope, brain is full?
And took advantage of virtual features like the chat.
Go ahead and type in the chat, what are the things that you're trying to learn right now? What are the things that you would like to improve? So I want you to answer this question in the chat. What's not wrong with your life?
We also put an emphasis on compelling, relevant, and funny content.
Share a recap with your roommate, your significant other, maybe your cat. You're gonna decide to use humor tomorrow, late at night, you're gonna go to bed, and then you're gonna wake up in the morning and decide to use humor to not just conquer the world, but maybe conquer some of your projects. That's your agenda, not just for now, but for the next 24 hours. I first learned about this model at PNG. My manager told me it's gonna take you a year to go from non-consciously incompetent to non-consciously competent. I was like, sweet. Does that mean you don't expect anything from me for an entire year? And he's like, no, that's not what I'm talking about. Like, just recognize that there are gonna be times that you start to feel overwhelmed or start to feel like you can't possibly do all of the different ins and outs that you're expected to do. But recognize with practice and repetition, it becomes second nature. 55% of the employees are unsatisfied with their job. In fact, here in the United States, more people believe in ghosts than like what they do for a living. And think about that. That means the average person like, I want to kill my boss, but I can't because then they come back and haunt.
It's no doubt that we're living in challenging, uncertain times, but people still need inspiring and engaging content, even if that means having it delivered in a way that they're not quite used to. For us, we wanted to empower people with the skill of humor so they can adapt to whatever comes next and stay sane doing it.
Right? You are what you repeatedly do. You are the author of your own story, and you are responsible for your own happiness. So why not choose to be more productive, less stressed, happier? Why not choose to get better results and have more fun? Why not choose humor that works?